The time t required to do a job varies inversely with the number of people p working on the job. If it takes 6 hours for 8 workers to complete a job, how long would it take if there were 9 workers? So sometimes when we have an inverse variation application like this, it's a little more challenging to find the inverse variation equation because the important information is hidden within this first sentence. We need to be able to read this first sentence and realize the most important information is that t varies inversely with p, where t is the time and p is the number of people. The general inverse variation equation is y equals k divided by x, where k is the variation constant. But for this equation, we would say y varies inversely with x. Here we have t varies inversely with p, so the inverse variation equation that we'll use here is t equals k divided by p. From here we're told it takes 6 hours for 8 workers to complete a job. So if t is equal to 6, then p is equal to 8. Again, where t is time, which we'll assume is in hours, and p is the number of people. So we can use this information to determine the variation constant and then answer the question about how long it will take if there are 9 workers. So we'll substitute 6 for t and 8 for p. So to solve this equation for k, we'd multiply both sides of the equation by 8. Remember, this is 8 over 1, so this simplifies to 1 here. So we have 8 times 6, or 48, is equal to k, or k equals 48. Notice what we did here is multiplied both sides of this equation by p, so we could have found k by finding the product of p and t, which we did here by solving this equation. But there's also this second inverse variation equation down here below that says x times y equals k, which we could have used using the variables p and t. Either way, for this situation, the equation that relates the time and the number of workers is t equals 48 divided by p. And now to answer the question how long it would take if there were 9 workers, we're going to substitute 9 for p and then determine t. So we'd have t equals 48 divided by 9. Notice how this question does not state how to express the answer. So we'll express this a couple of ways. If we're allowed to express this in decimal form, we can go ahead and just perform this division. Let's start with that. We'd have 48 divided by 9, which would be 5.3 repeating in decimal form. Remember, 0.3 repeating is equal to 1/3. So in decimal form, we could express this as 5.3 repeating, and this would be hours. If we're asked to round this to the nearest tenth, we could say it's approximately 5.3 hours. But again, because 0.3 is repeating, we could also express this as 5 1/3 hours. And the reason this might be helpful is sometimes you may be asked to express your answer in hours and minutes. And since there are 60 minutes in 1 hour, 1/3 of an hour will be 20 minutes. So we could also express this as 5 hours, 20 minutes. So there are several ways to express this answer based upon what your question might state. One thing we can mention though is that notice when there were 8 people, it took 6 hours. So by adding one more person, the job was completed 40 minutes earlier. I hope you found this helpful.